This is the time for questions and answers, and I'm looking forward to your questions. Please.
Okay, so something that I'm wondering about is, as I listen to you explain the four existential body models, I can actually even comprehend how all these bodies can work together, how they're a kind of correlating concern, right? I love the idea that from spirit, from a type of energetic force, it can ignite and, let's say, be the energetic stimulus to a thought process that then becomes something embodied, a creation. I love that. And then a notion that creation is understood as, you were talking about that idea of there's causal planes, and then there's a line in space, and there's a physical manifestation. So I'm following all that logic. And even as we're in this opportunity, then there's something that says to me, but how do we know? I am just a physical body. I mean, I'm in a physical world, and I'm observing physical laws that tell me if I jump in front of a train, I probably won't be here. Not because I've tried it, it's just because on the news, someone has done that, right? So I'm observing physical laws. But how can I test your model of creation, I think is what I'm trying to get to. How do I know that any of it exists? In the way that you have described this to us?
Excellent question. This is the question that all of us have. And the answer is very crisp and very real. If you are expecting from your physicality to convince yourself that what I am saying is true, don't try. Because simply, as we said, anything that happens in the causal planes is not observable on the basis of our senses. Therefore, all of it is beyond the physical world. It is metaphysics. It is metaphysics. Now, the question, though, is very real. How will I know? The answer is that if you cannot know on the basis of your senses, the only way that you can approach this question and come to a certain negotiating agreement and understanding, interpretation, will be through cognitive processes. It will be on the basis of your personal interpretation, which will be based on your understanding and your personal knowledge. Which means that you will be able to know that these things happen if they satisfy your inner self. The only way that you can have a sense of realization that this is true is if you attend the way you are resonating within your heart. If what I am telling you leads to a certain resonance that you feel that something is there, then this is the green light which is given by your inner self that you are on the right track to further investigate and understand more. This understanding, which is the second level of consciousness, is evidence that you are on the right track. When I was explaining all of these things, you notice that I was first one to admit that they have to be understood. They are created by cognitive processes, and therefore they are a mental construct. It's the way you will understand and you will satisfy yourself that these things may be true. Absolutely true, you have to remain until you die, and then you get more evidence. I had the benefit of being dead. You know that. And when I was dead, I had the realization that I was more alive while I was dead than otherwise. So, as a matter of fact, I am convinced that I had this opportunity of dying twice just to convince myself that what I already understood through my personal communication was real. So I was given this chance. However, while I was dead, I never felt fear that I died. I had a party. I was a tourist. Okay? I belong to this, if you wish to call it, minority of people who had this opportunity, and I am convinced that it happened to me just to realize how truly I have reached to a certain understanding, how truly I was on the right track, so that upon return I will devote my life into sharing these ideas, these proposals with other people, and allow them to make a decision whether or not it is useful to them or not. So keep that in mind. This is nothing more than a proposal for you. However, it's a proposal that it is logically tight. You just have to read more, you have to listen more presentations, you have to read the book and other books, and at a certain point all of this might increase your certainty. But you will be the only one who will go through this process for yourself. I cannot do an experiment to prove you that I am right, because all of these things are only proposals. What you should ask yourself is, how do you feel about that? Does it sound reasonable? Is it possible that it requires more interpretation? If you resonate with the thoughts, then carry on. If you discard it, as many people do, then it doesn't make sense for you to carry on. The final analysis, you will say when you are satisfied with the explanations or not. And please, don't get convinced because I said anything. I only give you a hint of what exists. The proof will come through you, through your own development, because the more you increase your consciousness, the higher you are going to reach and the more you understand the proposal. Experimentation cannot be done at this level, not yet. And it's a matter of personal trip, personal process of developing to reach to a certain point of accepting as a possibility or not. Given the time, you will know. Like, I had the chance to die because I knew all of these things, and then I came back with the assurance that I was right. But I don't wish anybody to die because, no, not everybody is ready for that. I was. So, the answer, the short answer is, look how you resonate with the proposal. If you do not react negatively, then most likely you should carry on. Decision is yours and yours all alone. I hope I answered the question.
I think another question I have following.
Excuse me. Is it on now? Is this on?
Yeah. Yes, it is. Yeah.
Start again.
Following what we were just discussing, which is that idea of where's the proof? How will I know who I am? What am I doing here? The question I have is somewhere along the lines of, we come into the world. I remember holding my child and thinking that from the first moments, my child expressed a lot of uniqueness. And from those first moments, they continue to be exactly who they mean to be. And I look at them and go, how is it? How do we, at a soul level, hold on to who we are? And how do we, on some level, you talked about a resonance, a kind of relationship with knowing, trusting our inner voice. How would you suggest, based on the model we were just looking at, how do you suggest we approach a world which is constantly trying to shape our thoughts and tell us what to believe? And a world, on some level, I'm living into a world where we just think man is supposed to suffer, or man is sinful, or this is just the way it is. Like, how, based on your model, how would, like, my children, you know, they'll say to me things like, well, I'm an agnostic, or I'm an atheist, or, you know, they're in their own minds trying to understand what it means to be here on this planet. And they react really strongly against dogma or anyone else trying to tell them what it all means, like from when they were little. And so I know this is a lot of words, and what I'm trying to get is, how would you suggest, let's say if I think this message has great value and it moves me actually very deeply, and I go, I could see lots that's possible here and open to interpretation. And I guess what I'm wondering then is, how would I begin to approach other people or share this idea? I mean, you said to me, well, there is a book, which is really an incredible book, but how would I start to share some of these understandings with, which doesn't force an opinion or is not dogmatic, but it presents the possibility and the model without imposing on them these thoughts? I don't know if that's clear.
Okay. I get the question. And the general answer to your question relates to the personal consciousness of any creation. In other words, what a particular creation discerns, understands, knows through personal experience. For example, I talk about my personal trip, and I mentioned that the final assurance in my thinking and the impetus to devote my life into trying to explain to people a different perspective of what exists, cosmotheory, in other words, came after death. And that means that I had an actual experience, a personal experience about the world beyond our senses. If you ever talk to a person who had a serious heart attack, my first heart attack was so strict, that so serious, that they were giving every half an hour reports to my wife whether or not I'm going to survive. And for 8 days I was just traveling back and forth. I had great fun. Now, to reach to this particular point, and incidentally, my heart works by 22%. Yet I'm doing very well, thank you. Okay? Only by itself, just to analyze this particular realization, it takes a bit of wondering. Well, what I'm trying to say here is that I had actual experience. I know what I'm talking about. I have reached to the knowledge level on this thing. And I paid for that. Yet after that, I devoted 15 years of my life, and hopefully I will stick around 15 more years, doing the same thing, in hoping that more people will get a glimpse and will ask more questions, seek for more answers, and believe me, they will never get all their answers. Instead, they are going to get even more questions. The more I'm getting involved with this subject, the more questions I identify. And the deeper I go, what is truly important is that all my answers for all the questions that I'm creating for the last 15 years are coming from this model. Okay? That gives me all the answers. However, I can put down my questioning. I can tell you there are a lot of questions you can ask, and a lot more that you will discover after you ask these questions. But without questions, you cannot get answers. And at this particular point, when I am explaining, the best thing I'm looking forward is to give you an opportunity to create more questions. The questioning, the inquiring, the actual continuous effort that will give you some logical assurance, some philosophical resolution of what is happening in the cosmos beyond our senses is my objective. And it is the only thing I am offering. So everything depends on consciousness, but consciousness requires not just understanding, but personal experience. And personal experience is not something that it is easily attained. People are going to the universities and they are reading books and books and books, which are the opinions of other people. In reality, they are most often proposals. Okay? And then if they learn them by heart and write them in their final exams, and they pass and they become scientists or whatever, okay, with the knowledge of other people, many of which never had the real knowledge, but they are only proposing, okay, they don't go very far. And that's the difference between real scientists and people who are working in science. Yeah? So what I'm saying is, this is a long process. And the kids, in general, they have this attitude of knowing all because they don't know enough. So as a parent, you're going to have to face that and just be there and explain them when they are ready. The best way to be able to spread the word is to ask questions. Ask questions and ask the people to answer them on the basis of what they know. If they are serious enough, they will start thinking like you. Maybe they are developed enough to understand your questioning and then see your train of thought, and then they start searching and you helped. You helped them particularly, and the community at large through the collective consciousness layer, which is the real target. Okay? So ask questions and ask them to answer.